Tristan Michael from Red Chair Diaries, as as you well know. I'm recording this a second time. There was no sound the last time I did it because I decided to use the laptop and the different configurations, but I used the same webcam anyway. So I'll try to remember what I said. Since it was from the heart, I should be able to. We discussed in the past Michael Jackson, and we don't see things exactly the same way about Michael Jackson. I'm not a big fan, but I'm not here to rehash that. That's not the point of your video, and it's not the point of my video. The point of my video is that I think your recent video here about 2 years on already, believe it or not for me, right, that Michael Jackson passed away, and you are asking some very probing questions in there of the audience about, you know, who is there that has that effect, and that was doing that sort of humanitarian thing and operating on several levels. You spoke more eloquently than I can about it because you're passionate about it, but I found your video actually quite moving, and I think it's too... I couldn't remember the expression in the other recording either. To your credit, that's the expression, that you feel this way, actually, because it's so important for us to have people that we champion because we feel that they are a champion for causes that we believe in. So I really think that that's a wonderful thing. And so you were asking the question about who else is there, you know, I think in the celebrity world and so on. And I'm not going to talk about Angelina Jolie and all, you know, any of these United Nations, you know, advocates and so on. But I've been thinking, you know, of all the entertainers that I love, I don't feel a connection to any of them when it comes to the feeling that you were saying. And, you know, like, the closest I came to that or is probably when Elizabeth Taylor passed on. And it's not that I don't like a lot of stars, a lot of actors, actresses, writers, so on. But, you know, to me, she was the whole package. And I know that you appreciated her as well, and the way that you appreciate Michael Jackson and his impact on the world and on your world, you know, is very, very laudable. So I was thinking, like, I love Elton John and I love his music. I think he does so much, you know, for AIDS research and so on. But I don't feel an emotional connection to Elton John. And that's what you're talking about. You know, there's a visceral connection with that person, that entertainer, or that entity. So many Motown singers, I don't feel a particular connection. Love Barbra Streisand, I don't feel a particular connection. You know, though I was so excited when I saw her live in Las Vegas, as I told you about almost 12 years ago, that was about as close as I guess I've probably had to a nerdgasm in public. So I've been, you know, thinking about your question or your thesis, and I think the closest I've felt or feel to what you may feel for Michael Jackson is the way that I felt the impact of Diana, the Princess of Wales, and her death in August 1997. Now, I was a young lad, 45 then, and I remember that I was very, very distressed, you know? And it's the whole thing about being cut down in your prime, I guess, and, oh, the poor boys, and, you know, and of course I think that she had a raw deal from the royal family anyway, and, you know, so I was always predisposed to like her as well, in a way. But she's also one of the few mega celebrities that, of course, that I saw in the flesh when she went from the hotel in Vancouver at the opening of Expo 86 in May of 86, from the hotel to the limousine with Charles And Ted and I waited in line, like we didn't know this was going to happen. We were on the way to a restaurant that was opening that night in the Canada Pavilion. But I've read so much about her. I've watched the interviews, you know, and things like that. So, and you know, I don't care if there was artifice and how much of it might have been put on, and that she knew how to get the cameras to work to push her agenda, you know, for about the mines and AIDS and all of this, you know, and that's good. And Elizabeth Taylor knew that about Star Wattage and so on. Pardon me. So that's really, I think, about the closest that I can come to how you feel about Michael. Pardon me, Jackson. But that's dry wine. I don't know if it'll help. Anyway, I wanted to salute you and your friend there for your video, because I thought it was a very, very nicely done advocacy and tribute. So, Michael, from the other side of the world, Red Chair Diaries, Nova Scotia, Canada, to Tristan in, I think you're in Sydney still, aren't you? Australia. And very nice. Bye-bye.